This episode of Shoreline Anglers is brought to you by Musky Fool, Chippewa River Custom Rods, and Northward Pedal and Paddle.
Well, hi guys, back with Shoreline Anglers. Today we're going for big pike. You can have it.
Mm-mm. Don't horse them. Real. Keep it tight. Don't horse.
It's a big
pike. Oh my god.
Pike.
It might be mid-30s, maybe. Bring him over here. Oh yeah, we got a leader on him. That's good.
That's a big pike.
Don't let him run too hard. Mm-hmm. Just hold him, buddy. Good job. That's a nice fish, Hank.
He's probably 34, 35, Caleb.
We'll see. Bring him over here. Yeah, I know. First fish of the day, and it's a dandy pike for my man Hank. Ugh, I might have to get in the water, brother. Actually, I'm bringing him over here.
Careful, he's been on the hook.
I got him, buddy. Oh, yeah.
You got him?
Oh, heck yeah.
Him up here?
Oh, heck yeah.
Will you bring him up here?
Dude, heck yes.
Will you come up here?
Don't grab him super hard.
Will you take a photo?
Yep. Here. Oh my gosh. Hey, that's a nice treble hook. Heck yeah.
Well, yeah, but you need to put your stuff all in one container of some kind.
I'm working on it, Grandpa.
Well, that's good.
Just wait till I'm organized. Then I won't be stopped. This chair comes in handy, though, every once in a while.
Having the hook caught in something?
No.
Oh.
The chair.
Oh, yeah.
We got a fish hitting our cup bait right now. I'm gonna set the hook for Arlo. Oh crap. Yeah. Big cat daddy.
Cat daddy.
Big cat daddy. Real. You're good. Just don't horse it. Let me check your drag. Yeah, it's a big cat daddy.
Bigger than the one yesterday?
I think it might be bigger than the one yesterday. Good stuff. Yes, sir.
Is this the cut open one?
Yep.
Jeez. Ah.
Right. It's not as big as the one yesterday. When I set the hook, he felt big.
Yeah. How'd you know it was a cat?
Still nice size.
I know when the cat daddies are on.
Smile, Arlo.
Yeah, you should have seen the one we had yesterday. It's still big, but.
Well, hey, if they're biting, that's cool.
Yeah.
And it didn't take long, really.
Yeah.
No, it didn't take long at all. What was on there?
Cut bait.
There.
He's fat too.
Get in there. Nice little at daddy.
Yeah.
Squeaker.
Nice chunky one.
Still. There you go.
Nice start to the day. Little at daddy show.
Something's biting.
Okay, so for at daddies, what we're doing. We had some leftover suckers and chubs from last night, so what I do, give them one little slit down the belly like that, open them up, let some stenches out, and I have one of these offset worm hooks bass fishermen use, stick it in his back, weave it on down through the fish, like this, and then I stick it out like that right there, and I put a leader on it because we do get muskies on these, honestly, and northern, so... But that's what we're rigging for at daddies. Second at daddy hooked up.
Gotta get him away from the other pole.
Yeah, when you reel, you gotta crank. I'm casting this one out, might as well. Okay, pliers.
Holy cow.
Are the pliers over there?
He's been beat up.
Just wait. I know, I saw him. I jumped.
It's got a fish on it.
Oh. What's up with this tickle?
I don't know.
Poor guy.
Jeez. Holy cow.
He's got her in his gill, so I'm just going to cut this one. There you go, buddy. Let's show off that little guy. Look at that tail, though.
Here, is that from being attacked?
Grab the camera. Oh,
look at that tail.
Is that from being attacked or what?
I think it's a little disease or something.
Oh,
he's got some up here, too.
Oh, yeah.
Because look, it's like, it's got some brown on it too and some leeches and stuff. Should we get those leeches off of them even? Yeah, they're laying eggs on them and stuff.
Uh-uh.
No. We don't want you guys on our at daddies. One bit.
Oh my gosh.
And even if it's not, I'll get his gills in the water. Even if it's not, we're still doing him a little favor, I think, somehow. Mm-hmm. He's got one more fatty over here. All right. No, it'd be cool. All right, there we go. All right, buddy. Thank you for playing. I'm gonna be fishing with suckers under bobbers. And I'm gonna cast a whopper plopper to start, and I bought a jerk bait. It's a little bit deeper out there, I think. But I like to have that sucker swimming above. So I'll probably put it about 4 feet probably. Yes. Wrap that up. Get a sinker on there. And we'll see what happens. Start one there. All right, we got our two suckers out, two very good spots. I'm gonna run a whopper plopper, I think. Bobber down. Bobber down, bobber down, bobber down. Oh, it went back up. He dropped it. He dropped it. He hit it again. He picked it back up. All right, 3, 2, 1. We got him. Decent bass, not huge. Nice, not a big bass, but definitely a nice starter. Hey, thank you, nice job. There we go, 16, 15. There we go. Yeah, that's the spot I was getting him at ice fishing. Right out there. I'm gonna have to be way quicker next time. Right there. Okay. And I just want to cast that whopper plopper a couple times. But I'm gonna come back and fish over there. Think about. Bobber down. Bobber down. Bobber down. Okay. Okay. So that bobber just went down. I don't know if that one's coming back. That's the spot. That's definitely the spot. So it looks like today is going to be done when we run out of suckers. Well, let's see how quick this thing gets hit. Put that one there. I'm gonna go grab that other one and put it to the right. Bobber down as soon as it was casted out. Got him. This pole's janky. Get him out of those woods.
yeah, dude. Heck yeah. Whoa, that one's a pretty one. Very pretty fish. One hook in it. There we go. You really can't beat live bait. I don't do this often, but this is a lot of fun. Wow. There we go. 16, 17 incher, maybe 1.5, 2 pounds. Bang, bang, bang. Okay, so I'm gonna film this, the whole thing this time, see if it happens again. It's happened 3 times now. Hook up sucker, well, chub, I guess. Hook up chub. I hook up chub. I cast chub out. Right there. That time, she didn't go down right away. She's not in the same spot though, but we'll get this one there. You good, buddy? You still lively? It's down. It's down. It's down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, click. I lost it. She might come back. This pole is very, very light. That's why I'm setting the hook like that. This one will be better. I'd rather be catching on this one. 100%. So, we'll get her out in the hot spot. I'm just gonna check this one just to be safe. First one I missed. Oh, tighten the drag too. There we go. We won't miss the next one. I'll reel it in slow. Whew, I'm hot. I think they might even like that splash. No, I'm gonna cast this one more to the left. No, I'm gonna bring them shallow. Here, there. And I'm getting organized. Please don't drop it. I'm gonna give them a line and I'm gonna check my drag. Here we go. Got him. I'm waiting for the 22 to come out. This might be, oh my God, what is it? Or he's small. He's either small or he's big and he's just letting me drag him in. Or he's small and in weeds, that's what it is. Howdy, buddy. I'm sorry about that. He was like, I'm done. He's just done with me. Never mind. All right, whoa, he almost took my pole in the water. There. Tangled me up a little bit there, bud. And you're not as small as I thought. Nice. Okay, that's the biggest one so far, 100%. Definitely. Beauts. Largies are fun, 100%. Ooh. To our last sucker. I just wanted a big one though. Well, I mean, it's not that they're not big, but this is the last time he said he's letting anyone fish his pond this year because he's deer hunting. So I wanted to see one of those big bucket mouth chunkers. Fun to see a walleye too, even. It's big. I'm surprised you didn't get picked up over there. It's very weird. I think there's a hump over here or something because they love it over there. Maybe some weeds for the bluegills to chill in. I don't even know. Five, four, three, two, one. I want her to move and then I'm gonna set the hook. This could be a big fish. Oh, there's the popper. No, he's not moving. He's coming towards me. Ready? Drag slipped. Another little guy in the weeds. They get in those weeds and they don't want to fight or something. Oh, he's swimming. As soon as I get those weeds off him, he might go crazy. Like that last one. Oh, and there goes the sucker. That would have been nice to save, but wait. There. They're all so pretty. Oh, look at him bite my finger. All right, so we got that one sucker left. I'm gonna cast out this little guy on a jig head. Hook him through the mouth. Should I put a twister on too? Yeah, I'm going to. It's a big jig head. We'll see what they think of this. I'm not completely sure myself. Got another bobber down. Oh crap. I'm gonna have to do this quick. It's gonna have to be like tape up fishing. I got weeds on my line. All right, reel. There, I got that one. That's the bigger one. Not the chunky chunky I was looking for, but that's a bigger fish. Okay, that's a chunky chunky. That's a chunky chunky on the last sucker. Okay, that's a chunky chunky. Okay, not as big as I thought, but a chunky chunky. Nope, that's as big as I thought. Thank you, my friend, making my day. Thank you, buddy. Perfect fish to end the day on. 3-pounder. Wow, so pretty. Look at those scales. Gosh, I love it. Got a spider on him. Get off of him. You ready to go, buddy? Yeah, thank you. I'll let you go. Heck yeah, dude. Heck yeah.